We are going to continue with the application of derivative, and L'Hopital rule also we may apply to infinity over infinity forms. Here we have polynomial functions, and I explain in limit topic for the polynomial functions. When we have polynomial functions, it's easy to solve with the limit method, because the method was like this. Here, if the powers are same, we were naming like m is equal to n, if you remember that letters also. M is equal to n, then the limit was equal to a over b. It was like this. So for this question, the limit it's going to be equal to 1, the coefficient is equal to 1, the coefficient is equal to minus 3, so the answer is going to be equal to 1 over minus 3, because this is infinity over infinity form. Let's try to find this one by using the L'Hopital rule. First, we should analyze that one. It's going to be infinity over infinity form. Here, infinity square is greater than infinity, so it's going to be this side, it's going to be infinity upper side, and the down is here 2x minus infinity. Infinity over minus infinity, it's going to be the result. So this is a infinity over infinity indeterminate form. Then, if it is indeterminate form, infinity over infinity, we may apply the L'Hopital rule like we were applying in the 0 over 0 indeterminate forms, and we will get the derivative here. So limit x tends to infinity, x squared minus 3x plus 5. I'm rewriting the question again to see the steps, all the steps here. 2x minus 3x squared, we understood that this is infinity over infinity. Then we are going to, here we are going to get the derivative of numerator and denominator. Limit x tends to infinity, x squared minus 3x plus 5 over 7 plus 2x minus 3x squared is going to be the derivative. The derivatives of the numerator and denominator. Here the derivative of limit x tends to infinity, the derivative of x squared is going to be equal to 2x, and derivative of minus 3x is equal to minus 3, it's going to be, and the plus 5 is 0, that's why I didn't write. The derivative of 7 is equal to 0, derivative of 2x is equal to 2, and derivative of minus 3x squared is equal to minus 6x is going to be. When I apply here when I apply infinity over infinity to this question, I'm going to recognize that. Let's see. Also, that's like that. Infinity over minus infinity, it's going to be again. So here we may apply the L'Hopital rule one more time, which means limit extends to infinity 2x minus 3. I'm going to rewrite this one one more time. That's why I'm not going to apply the derivative. 2x minus 3 over 2 minus 6x is equal to limit extends to infinity. Here it's going to be equal to 2x minus 3 is going to be equal to derivative 2x minus 3 over derivative of 2 minus 6x going to be. And when you get the derivative of the 2x minus 3, it's going to be equal to limit x tends to infinity 2 over minus 6. The derivative of 2 is equal to 0, derivative of minus 6x is going to be equal to minus 6. The answer is 2 over minus 6. Here we don't have any variable, that's why the answer it's going to be directly what is the term it is, which means 2 over 6, and 2 over 6 is equal to minus 1 over 3. As you see, to find this one by using the limit rule was easier. Generally, we are not going to apply for the polynomial functions. If the functions are not polynomial and if you have infinity over infinity, we are using L'Hopital rule for solving the questions. The second question, here actually we are using for this kind of questions infinity over infinity, because pardon, L'Hopital rule for infinity over infinity. Here you cannot factorize, or you don't have the polynomial functions. That's why you cannot decide about the power here, but it's going to be equal to infinity over infinity. First, c infinity squared is infinity. Infinity plus infinity, it's going to be, the result is infinity. Infinity squared, it's going to be equal to, pardon, e to the power of infinity, it's going to be, which is infinity, and the result, it's going to be infinity over infinity. And for this one, we are going to apply the L'Hopital rule directly. Limit x tends to infinity, e to the power of x plus 2x derivative. I'm going to apply directly, it's over e to the power of 2x plus minus 3, sorry, minus 3 derivative is going to be. Now, we have here e to the power of f x derivative, if we remember, it's equal to e to the power of fx times f derivative x, it's going to be. And e to the power of x derivative is the only derivative of the function, which is equal to itself, which is equal to itself, e to the power of x, it's going to be. So here, the result, it's going to be equal to limit x tends to infinity, x tends to infinity, e to the power of x derivative, I said it's equal to itself, plus 2 over e to the power of 2x, it's going to be e to the power of 2x times 2 x derivative minus 3 derivative is equal to 0. It's not written. As you see here, we haven't finished the derivative operation, and because again the results are here, e to the limit x tends to infinity, e to the power of x plus 2 over e to the power of 2x times 2, which is 2 times e to the power of x, it's going to be 2 times e to the power of x, it will be 2 times e to the power of 2x, it should be. Okay, then we are going to, here 2x, it's going to be, if we get the infinity here, e to the power of infinity, infinity, 2 to the power of e to the power of 2 infinity, infinity, infinity over infinity is going to be again. So we are going to continue to L'Hopital rule one more time, which is equal to limit x tends to, limit x tends to infinity, derivative of e to the power of x plus 2 over 2 times e to the power of 2x derivative is going to be, 2 is the coefficient here, that's why it's not going to affect operation, but this 2, it should be derivative of 2 plus 2, it is, that's why derivative of this 2 is going to be equal to 0. So limit x tends to infinity, derivative of e to the power of x is equal to e to the power of x, and derivative of 2 times e to the power of 2x times 2x derivative is going to be e to the power of fx times f derivative x, it must be, which is equal to limit x tends to infinity, e to the power of x over 4 times e to the power of 2x, it's going to be, and 2x derivative, because it's equal to 2, 2 times 2 is equal to 4, is going to be. And here again, infinity over infinity form we get, but this time, as you see, when you get the derivative of this expression, we don't have any constant term or here another function. As you see, again, we are going to get the same functions. So what we are going to do here? We know that e to the power of 2x is equal to e to the power of x to the power of 2 normally. So it's equal to limit x tends to infinity, e to the power of x over 4 times e to the power of x to the power of 2, which means when you simplify, this is going to be equal to limit x tends to infinity, infinity 1 over, this is e to the power of x times e to the power of x, so we simplify one of them, 4 times e to the power of x, it's going to be. And here we have, if it is, now when you apply the infinity, it's going to be equal to 1 over 4 times e to the power of infinity, which is equal to 1 over infinity, that's equal to 0. This expression, for this kind of expressions, we are going to do limit, first we should understand 0 from the positive side, it's going to be equal to infinity, and ln x, when you apply ln 0 from the positive side, That's going to be equal to minus infinity. We can easily understand this one from the graph. If you remembered to draw the graph, ln(x) function, we were drawing like this. And when you get closer to zero from the positive side, the function is going down here. And when the function going down, it reaches minus infinity for us. So limit 0 plus, it's going to be equal to minus infinity. So 1 over x infinity over minus infinity, it's going to be, we may apply L'Hopital rule for this question. Okay, then limit extends to 0 from the positive side. 1 over x, it's going to be over ln x is equal to the derivative of this expression. So it's going to be limit extends to 0 from the positive side. This is x to the power of minus 1 derivative I'm going to write here. And if you remember the derivative of ln x, it's going to be equal to 1 over x. So it's equal to limit extends to 0 from the positive side, x to the minus 1, x to the power of minus 2 over 1 over x, it's going to be, which is equal to limit extends to 0 from the positive side, minus 1 over x squared over 1 over x, it's going to be, which is equal to limit extends to 0 from the positive side, x goes up, so x over minus x squared, it's going to be, and that's equal to limit extends to here 0 from the positive side minus 1 over x, which is equal to minus 1 over 0 from the positive side. 0 from the positive side, normally this is infinity, but we have minus sign here, that's why the answer is going to be minus infinity. We solved the infinity over infinity problem here.